Look, if anybody shows up, like if anybody shows up, we'll read from the word. If anybody wants to do that, I mean, jeez, I don't think I can twist everybody's arm. I have a cool periscope out here. Welcome, Pablo. So look, you guys, here's the deal. I'm willing to read. Hey, dude. I'm willing to read if anybody wants me to. If anybody thinks that'd be cool. We'll read a little bit. But Pablo thinks that... I think that'd be cool. Okay. Sorry, I gotta get this shit straight. Alright. So you guys, let me know if you're here. What we're looking at is the Wisdom of Solomon. It's from the Apocrypha. As far as like what section of when this stuff was going on. And let everybody let me know how they're doing. Everybody can let me know how they're doing. Let me see who's here as well. We've got P-Moon here. And we've got, is that Jen? Who is this? Oh, we've got No One You Know. Okay, is here also. Okay, cool. So welcome, you guys. We got a couple of candles lit. I don't know if you can see them. You can't quite see them, but that's what we'll deal with. And then I'm going to go to the Word, if everybody's ready. I'm going to close this. I'm actually going to... Let me close these windows just because I'm a little bit annoyed out just because of life. Okay. It's not that I don't feel everybody don't need to hear my prayer, but I just want to have a little bit of space, you know. So you guys, I picked up the Apocrypha at the Goodwill recently. It's got plenty of books in the Bible in it. I was raised Catholic, so we always did have the Apocrypha in the Bible, you know. And it's just good connecting texts, okay? It shows the development of the word metaphysically. You can, like, just see it, you know? You compare it to the New Covenant developments, and you compare it against the Old Testament achievements, and things just make a lot of sense, you know? And I mean, in here, you've got the stories that are referred to in the New Testament. You got various wisdom books, you know, and you got tales and narratives of, you know, cool stuff. Okay. What we have here is the Wisdom of Solomon. This particular translation was put forth by Edgar J. Godspeed, for what that's worth. So this particular Wisdom Book of Solomon, you know, I don't know, it probably wasn't written by Solomon necessarily. In fact, it's like part of it was in Hebrew and then part of it was in Greek. The translators like put that together. So it's like one is a retelling or an extension of the first part of the tale. And it's about a fusion of the Greek and Hebrew ideas, you know, the languages meeting, right? So you can actually see the cultures and everything meet up in these Greek texts. They're worth studying, man. They're worth studying. So I figured I'd pick these up. And they're part of the canon to Catholics. Like, you're supposed to, if you're trying to study the Bible and stuff, you're supposed to understand this stuff for, as far as Catholics are concerned. I don't know why they don't come out clearer with Jesus' weed and Catholics, but I would come out stronger on that if I were setting the doctrines there for the Catholics. just me. It's just me, a guy who was raised Catholic, who wants to see fucking Christ reign. Who likes that? It's a Jesus-loving guy. Okay. So Paul loved this stuff, right? This is about 1st century BC this came out. Let's see who's here. If anybody's still with me. P-Moon's still with me. Oh, Cal the Cook's here? I'm gonna follow you, Cal. Okay. You guys, give me a heart if somebody's with me, and let me know that you're around. And then we'll start. Not seeing any hearts. Okay. Maybe I should restart.